do just a quick little introduction about myself, just like a 1 minute thing. Just in case you don't know me too well yet, you know, I have a lot of in-depth videos about the HCG protocol, and a lot of you are, you know, familiar with those. But for those of you who are new to me, I want to make sure you know that I'm coming from a background of having done this diet, okay? So I'm not a medical professional or anything. I'm just a regular person. I'm a mom, and I lost about 50 pounds with HCG injections. That was over 2 years ago that I lost all my weight, and I've been maintaining it for 2 years. And so along the way, I learned a lot of things that did work, that didn't work. I had a lot of struggles. I had a lot of triumphs. And I basically just started compiling all that information into videos and into articles to help other people on the diet who, you know, who had the same struggles I did. So that's just a little bit of background on me. I started out at a size 16, 18, and I've been a size 4 for about 3 years now. So anyway, I hope that just gives you a little background on me, and now we'll go ahead and get into the topic of our discussion. HCG Chica, this is going to be a very short, just brief overview of the HCG diet protocol, just to give you the main steps, okay? And as I speak, if you have more questions, which no doubt you will, as I'm talking, you'll probably be like, oh, well, what about this? And what if that happens? I have a lot of really detailed, in-depth articles and videos probably addressing your question. So if you just go to hcgchica.com, you'll see a section for phase 2 questions, phase 3 questions, a learn section, and you'll be able to easily navigate and find what it is that you're looking for, okay? But this is just to give you a brief overview. So there's basically 5 steps to getting through the HCG diet. And what I'm going to be sharing with you is the original protocol that Dr. Simmons came up with. Now, I'm not saying that this is the only way that it should be done. Myself and others have made various tweaks to the protocol with success, so I am not opposed to that. However, you guys need to have that right to make your choice as to how you want to do the diet. So I'm going to present to you Dr. Simmons' original protocol in this video. And in another video, which I'll link to in the article that goes with this, I will link you to, you know, tweaks that myself and others have made to the various phases, okay? All right, so first of all, let's just cover the 5 steps. Step 1, start taking HCG, load for 2 days on high fat and high calorie foods. Step 2 is phase 2, which usually lasts 3 to 6 weeks, and you take HCG while being on a specific 500 calorie diet. Step 3 is when you transition off of HCG. This takes 72 hours. Step 4 is phase 3, which lasts for 3 weeks. And then step 5 is phase 4, which is just pretty much regular everyday life where you gradually try to reincorporate starches and sugars. So let's go over each of those steps briefly. So step 1 was you start taking HCG and you load for 2 days on high fat, high calorie foods. So you begin taking HCG the morning that you start that loading phase. So you know, if you're taking injections, you'll take your HCG shot in the morning, or if you're doing drops, you'll take your first set of drops. And then for the next 2 days, you're going to be loading on high fat, high calorie foods. Now during this time, most people do gain weight during the loading phase. Not always, but most do, and that's normal. It comes off very quickly within the first day or two when you start the low calorie diet. So the question is, what exactly can you eat? Pretty much you can eat whatever you want. Again, the focus though is high fat and high calorie, but you can eat whatever you want. I have a pretty detailed post talking about, you know, why you might want to consider loading clean, which means to do the loading phase without desserts and without carbs. And so I'll link to that in this article, and you can check it out if you like. All right, so let's move on to step 2, which is phase 2. This is where you're taking HCG and you are doing the 500 calorie diet. So this usually is done for a period of 3 to 6 weeks. Again, you're taking HCG during this time, obviously. And It's also referred to as VLCD, which stands for very low calorie diet. So there's kind of three ways it's referred to: the 500 calorie diet, the VLCD, or phase two or P2. Those are all referring to the exact same thing, the period of time when you're taking HCG and you're losing weight. So that's all that means. So when you do a 3 to 6 week batch of time on HCG, when you complete that, that's considered one round of HCG, where you know you're finished with that, and then you take a break, which we'll talk about in another video, and then you can do another round later on to lose an additional, you know, chunk of weight if you have more to lose. Now, what's important about the 500 calorie phase two portion is that it's not just any 500 calories. You know, that would be hard enough, but no, we have to make it harder, but there is a very good reason for it. So the 500 calories comes from a very specific food list, and the way the food is apportioned out, like, you know, how you can eat that food is also very specific. So for all the details on how to do phase two, the very basics of that, that's in another video that I'll link to in this article, okay? So, but just keep that in mind that, you know, you can't just eat whatever you want to 500 calories. It's very specific in how it is. All right, so step three was transition off of HCG, and this takes 72 hours. So you basically, during this time, you stop HCG. You're transitioning off of it. So what this means is it takes about 72 hours for the HCG hormone to get out of your system. So in order to do that, basically during that time, your body's still, because it still has some of the hormone in you, your body's still more sensitive than normal to calories and fats. So what you do is you stop taking HCG. And then for the next 72 hours after your very last dose, you continue the 500 calorie diet. That's the basics on that, okay? So, and the 72 hours starts from the moment you take your last dose of HCG, okay? And I have a whole post about that as well, which I will link to in this article that goes into all the details about that. Okay, step four is what we call phase three. And this is when there's no HCG, you know, you're not taking HCG, and you're stabilizing your new weight. That's the purpose of this, and it usually lasts for about 3 weeks. So what this involves is a period of the 3 weeks where you're eating no starches and no sugars. Now, during this time, you're gonna be attempting to stabilize your new weight within 2 pounds of your LDW. Now, LDW stands for last dose weight. Sometimes you might hear it called LIW, which means last injection weight. So that's just the weight that you are on the scale the morning of your last dose of HCG, okay? That's what you're, the weight that you're gonna be trying to kind of stay close to is, okay? So the idea is that you're trying to maintain within 2 pounds of that. Now, during phase three, like I said, no starches and no sugars during this phase. You're eating higher calorie again, of course. You're eating more food. It's just no starches and sugars. Now, what happens if your weight goes above 2 pounds, you know, 2 pounds higher than your LDW? At that point, the original protocol instructed to do what's called a steak day. A steak day is simply fasting throughout the main part of the day, drinking lots of liquids, lots of water, and then for dinner, you have, you know, one meal, which is dinner, and you have a large steak and a tomato or apple. So, and again, the steak, it doesn't have to be really tiny. He actually recommended it be a good juicy one. So a nice large steak, an apple or a tomato. And usually when you would do a steak day like that, your weight would fall back into range within that 2 pound window. And then you could, you know, carry on with P3. So that's that. Now, step five, the final step for the main protocol, is entering phase four, which is just regular life. You're going to gradually try to add back in starches and sugars. Now, you know, ideally, there's probably going to be some foods that you're no longer going to eat anymore. You know, truth be told, for me anyway, when I got overweight, there was certain foods that I ate a lot of that were just not healthy. Maybe if I ate them on occasion, it would be okay, but I had a very unhealthy kind of addiction to them. So, you know, it's not that you're gonna be able to eat anything and maintain your weight. I think any reasonable person would know that, right? So really what you're trying to do is seeing if you can have healthier starches again. And you know, for everyone, it's going to be different. I have some more, you know, like I said, for each of these phases, I have a lot more detailed information. So for this one, if you want to go to hcgchica.com/phase4, you'll see the posts that I currently have talking about phase four and, you know, helping you navigate that whole thing. Basically, what it comes down to with phase four, usually one of two things is what takes place as far as being successful long-term with maintaining your weight loss. The first one is that some end up just staying in phase three eating kind of for life, which is kind of like a low-carb way of eating. Some people maintain their weight the best that way, especially sometimes women who are in a slightly higher age bracket. They often find that they just can't have as many carbs and maintain their weight. So that, you know, that may be something to consider. And also, sometimes it just feels good for people having less carbs in their diet. They feel more clear-headed and things like that. So that's one way that people choose to kind of live in phase four. The second thing that can happen that can be successful is where you kind of experiment to figure out which foods, which starchy foods, which sugary foods you can eat without gaining, and which foods do cause you to gain. Because you'd be surprised, it's not necessarily, you know, all or nothing. For instance, myself, I found there are certain starches that I can eat without gaining weight. I can actually eat fries on occasion. I probably have them once a week. I can have, you know, just potatoes in general. I can have organic corn tortillas. I can have a lot of fruit. I have dried cranberries. You know, those have sugar added to them. So those are the types of things I discovered I can have and my body seems to handle it well, you know, within balance. However, you might find there's other starches that you try adding in that do cause gains, you know, like maybe wheat or, you know, gluten, stuff like that. So just that's the other thing that you'll end up doing is realizing that you can have carbs in your diet, just not any carbs. There might be certain ones, and that's going to be part of an experiment that you'll have to figure out. So anyway, I hope that that was helpful. I wanted to keep this as short as I could. Again, this is the original Simeon's diet for HCG, and like I said, if you check out the article that goes with this video or the podcast, whichever you're listening to, you'll be able to find links to more in-depth answers. You know, you might have come up with some questions along the way as I was explaining this to you. So I hope that that helps. Stay tuned. We're going to have a short video covering the basics of phase two and the basics of phase three. There's just, yeah, a lot of other good stuff on hcgchica.com. You guys can find me on Facebook, hcgchica. Instagram, HCG Chica, just everywhere, you know, wherever you want to find me, just search HCG Chica, you'll probably find me. All right, you guys, take care. Bye.